Hello, I'm Wei Zhen. Today I will show you how to do a large diameter bore house. First one, you need to understand in Hong Kong, you can simply classify into two types. The first one is a shallow foundation. It's if your building is, the loading is not very large, for example, it's a three-story building, normally we try to use the shallow foundation and then we can rest on the soil, it's good enough. But if this is a, for example, it's a 30-story or 40-story buildings, you need to have a power foundation. In Hong Kong, there's two common assumptions. The first one is embedding, and the second one is the friction. Embedding is something like we rest on the wall, and then we call the embedding. And then the second one is friction, like the Giffenage power. The capacity is determined by the soil and the power between, and we call the friction power. And also in Hong Kong IELTS exam, normally they will testing your two wording. Many students have a confusion of two wordings. The first one is so-called the replacement. Replace is something like replace the soil and then replace to the concrete. That means, for example, large diameter bore pile, you take out the soil and replace to the concrete. Then we call replacement pile. Another type is so-called the displacement. Displacement is just something like it's just driven to the ground, and then something like you can imagine something like is the friction power. And that's why if you know the wording, normally you know how to answer. The displacement power is something like the Giffenage power, the replacement power is the large diameter bore power. This is show you the common types of the power foundation and the shallow foundation. You can imagine something like this. This one for the shallow foundation, and the and the capacity may not be very large, and then large diameter bore power, they due to the wall level, and the PBH power is also due to the wall level. Mini power is also only the Giffenage power use the skin friction, and then they can just rest on the soil. That's why from this previous drawing, you can know the foundation is to prevent the settlements and of the building, and prevent any movement of the building, and also prevent the uplifting, maybe due to the window or due to the water pressures. And due to the window, it will be overturned. That's why we need to have a foundation system. And this is show you the capacity of the foundation. Normally, you need to remember large diameter bore power, the capacity is about 70,000 kilonewton per pulse. But you can take a look of the mini power, only 1,000 something. That means this is about 30 times for different types of the capacities. That's why if your building, the loading is very small, try to do or try to choose mini power instead of large diameter bore power. This is show you the figure, what is so called the overturning. During the dead load issue, the loading will be uniform, go to the soil, and during the wind load, it will be forming the up and down. And then combine two together, this is so called the resultants. That means if your foundation is not strong enough, it will be overturning. This is show you the picture, what is the power rested. For example, last time with the bore power, they rest on the embedding and rest on the wall. And this is so-called the embedding power. And the second one is a so-called the friction. This is like the Giffenage power. They will not rest on the wall, and then they just depends on the friction between the steel beam and the saw. And this is so-called the common equipment you need to understand. And these are so-called vibrators, oscillators, rotators, webs, and LCD. I will show you what they are. Oscillator is something like this. You can imagine how can we drill the steel casing inside the soil. We use the oscillator to move clockwise and anti-clockwise, and then the steel pipe, tempered steel casing will be lower down. And then this is a so-called drilling head. And the first one is the drill bit. You can take a look in the front is a diameter. They can drill to the hard materials. This is also, and then this is a bell out bit. And then once we lower down, this will be enlarged and form the bell out. And this is a so-called grappers, and LCD is a so-called reverse circulation drilling machine. And they use the actually they connect this one, the two bit, and then they can move clockwise, and then they can choose the hard materials. This is a so-called a typical foundation pans. If you are the architect, just you need to understand is for example, this is a so-called pile cap. What is the pile cap below is a six piles for each pile caps, and then go to the section, we can find out the so-called this is a so-called wall head. This simple is the wall, and then you can see the pile is rest on the wall, and then we go to the level, and it's something minus 60 meters. That means if the ground level is zero, you can estimate the length of the pile is 60. And this is show you the common procedure how to do the large diameter ball piles. The first one, we do the pre-drilling to find out the wall head level, and then we drill the steel casing, and then form the belt out, and then do the keening and putting the steel reinforcement and concreting. This is a so-called the completion of the pile. This is a so-called the pre-drilling machine, and then actually they do a temper casing to the ground and take out the sample of the soil material. If they take out the soil material is the wall, we can determine this is a so-called the wall head level. This is a very simple mechanism. And then this is a so-called the step one, how to drilling the steel casing to the ground. You can see the workers check the verticalities and then make sure this is a vertical, and use the so-called rotators and oscillator. They can move clockwise and anti-clockwise, and then the temper casing will be lower down. And this is a so-called grappers to do the drill the soil materials and hard materials and do the belt out. You can take a look of this one. Once we lower down, this is like the buttons, and then they will enlarge, and then they can form the belt out. This is another type of the chisel. It's also used to drill the hard materials. This is a RCD, reverse circulation drilling method, okay? Just they can keep on drilling, maybe turn clockwise, and then the drilling head with diamond can be drilled hard materials. And this is a so-called, show you how to do the belt. And then this one is show you once you keening, and then lower down the reinforcement and concreting. And you can imagine this is something like the simple construction of the piles. And this is so-called the testing. And for sonic test, one is a so-called the generators to generate the wave, and one is the receiver. You can imagine if the pile foundation, the intact and the quality is very good, and then the signal should be in ideal case should not be moved too large. But if the material sometimes they have a void and honeycombs, that means the quality is really not very good, and then the signal they will have a large difference. You can imagine to this distance there's some problems of the quality of the concrete. This is a very simple test, and can show you what is happening. Another test is a so-called Cotton test to find out the diameter of the ball piles. That's why what I'm saying before is a so-called the ball pile. The capacity is determined by the end bearing and the shaft fixation. The first one is the end bearing. End bearing is a how to find out the end bearing is remember grade 3 wall is we can assume is 5000 kPa is the capacity, and then once we have the area of the piles, and then we can find out the end bearing capacity. And this is a so-called the shaft fixation capacity. Remember 700 is a typical bonding we use, and then once we find out the parameter and then multiple the length and then multiple 700, we can find out the capacity of the shaft fixation. This is a so-called end bearing assumption, is a so-called find out the area of the piles, and this is a QB, is the end bearing stress. We use 5000, and then we can find out the base capacities. and this is a so-called this is actually the formula how to do the shock friction resistance. This is shock resistance is 700, and this is the length. For example, this is a drill to the 5.8 meters, and this is a diameter multiple pi is a so-called parameter. Parameter of the power multiple length multiple 700, we can find out the shock friction, and we find out the embedding capacity is the same. It's a 5,000 multiple area of the diameter. This is two diameters multiple pi and divided by 4. This is a very simple formula to find out the circular diameters. Okay, and then we sum two figures together. This is so-called power foundation capacity. Well, thank you.